Well, those were the top stories that we have been tracking all day today. But let's go across to Manisha Natarajan for the big story of the day. The Bombay High Court today set aside the coastal regulation zone clearance that had earlier been granted to this 14,000 crore rupee project, which proposed to connect Marine Drive to Mumbai Coastal Road project. Manisha, over to you.
Thanks so much. Well, yes, it's a significant victory for urban planners and environmentalists. Bombay High Court has allowed the PIL filed by them and has held that the work on the coastal road cannot proceed without environmental clearance. Now, Mumbai is clearly divided on the issue on the need for building a coastal road to improve connectivity in the city. Let's get you both sides of the viewpoints on this boiling issue. We have with us the petitioner Shweta Wagh and Hafiz Contractor, who's a noted architect who believes it's a disservice to the city to not have the coastal road. Shweta, I'm going to start with you first. Haven't really understood what is the big issue on environmental clearances. I believe that the government or the state lawyer said that we have all the clearances, while you say that the clearances have not been received for this project.
So the BMC had obtained a CRZ clearance for the project, but it argued that it did not require an environmental clearance. So I think today the High Court has said that it's mandatory for them to obtain an environmental clearance. What our lawyers pointed out in the courts during the hearings was that the procedure for obtaining an environmental clearance is significantly different from the procedure required for a CRZ clearance in terms of the scoping, the kind of studies required, etc. So another important aspect of the EC or the environmental clearance is that they are required to conduct a prior public hearing, which is consult the communities on ground and, you know, take their views on board before going ahead with a project of this magnitude. So the BMC attempted to bypass all these processes, and they claimed that they have a CRZ clearance. But what the High Court has done is also quashed the CRZ clearance that the BMC had obtained, because even the CRZ clearance was not, you know, what they argued was that the MOEF or the MCZ ZMA or the people who had granted the clearance had not applied, you know, basically there was no application on mine of on their behalf while granting these clearances, because the studies done by the BMC
so Shweta,
are inadequate, and there is no reflection of the reality on ground.
All right. Well made point, Shweta. Just wanted to understand, what is your fear as a urban conservationist? What is the fear that building of the coastal road can cause as a damage to the coast and the city?
The construction of the coastal road, we've been looking at the destruction for the over 3 months now, you know, over 6 months since the project has begun. And they are concretizing the coast. They are dumping boulders, debris, tons of cement in the, you know, in the shallow water areas along Mumbai's coastline, and completely destroying the sensitive coastal ecology. So one must also note that this area has significant biodiversity. In fact, it has significant geomorphic formations or rock formations which are more than 16 million years old. And these are also habitats for various kinds of species, you know, belonging to the intertidal and the shallow water areas. This area would be entirely destroyed by reclamation. In fact, certain scheduled one species like corals, several species of corals have been observed in this area. They have also been recorded. In fact, last week, I think four Olive Ridley turtles were rescued from that site. Olive Ridley turtle is a Schedule 1 species. So one must understand the ecological significance of the area. And another thing is also the artisanal fishing practices. So the artisanal fishers are the shallow water fishers who have been traditionally fishing here in this shallow water zone for generations. And this is their traditional fishing ground. So right. What the Coastal Road project will do will not just irreversibly destroy the coastal ecology, but also wipe out artisanal fishing practices across Mumbai's coastline. And these are also the spawning and breeding areas,
right,
and the habitats
Shweta,
for
let
many
me,
of these
let me also
species.
Most of these. All right, let me get Mr. Contractor's view also. I think you made some very significant points. Mr. Contractor, what is your belief? I believe that you think that the coastal road should be made. Do you believe that the cost of the connectivity should be that, you know, we should be willing to sacrifice something on the environment Explain to us.
I think it's completely wrong to say that we are going to destroy the environment. We are living in a city. We cannot be just saying that what is there, and if we are doing any new development, it is going to destroy the environment. This coastal road would ease out so much of a traffic. The amount of carbon dioxide that, you know, every car emits, you know, while going from A to B zone is colossal. We are spending hours and hours every day to go from south to north or north to south. The amount, this coastal road, to be very frank, you know, according to me, today is a really a very, very sad day. We could have generated acres and acres of green forest along with the coastal road. Now, that is creating an environment. The whole world is doing it. I feel that, you know, every development that is taking place or proposed in Mumbai is, you know, somebody or the other takes up an objection. Look at all the other cities. Each and every small city of India has a ring road. All our old roads are congested. It's like a human being. We need a bypass. If the bypass is not made, the city will die. And we need this coastal road. Every city has it. Why are we going against development?
Mr. Contractor?
Yes.
Mr. Contractor, just wanted to understand, is there not, I mean, most transport experts have said that there are other ways to improve connectivity. What is the point also of making traffic fast between Marine Drive and somewhere close to Pedder Road and then have a jam again there with vehicles coming fast but not having an outlet? So I'm just saying that, look, isn't there a better way to do it? Balance both? Yeah.
See, a city needs all kind of transportation. We are already putting up a hell of a lot of connectivity as far as the railway is concerned, as far as the tube is concerned. Okay, we are doing that. We also need, it's not just the railway. We need bus transportation. We need railways. We also need the cars. And you know, the coastal road would add up so much of greenery. That is how, you know, we have to increase the greenery also.
Okay, let me get Shweta's argument on this. Shweta, last question here. On that greenery argument, what is your counter argument that, you know, there are so many green zones planned in this around this coastal road as well?
In fact, the area that is being reclaimed, and Mumbai's coastline has traditionally been a public space. You know, there are so many beaches, there are rocky areas, sandy areas, and these are actively used by people as open spaces. So we don't have a dearth of open spaces. In fact, the beaches themselves.
I would like to interrupt right now.
As far as creating forests on reclaimed lands in the sea. One needs to understand that the ecological function of a forest is, you know, the groundwater percolation, etc. So how does one call planting trees on reclaimed land or concretized land a forest? I think to equate that with a forest
Mr. Contractor, very quickly, your counter argument. I have to wrap
and,
out. Okay, go ahead, sir. Just one quick point. Shweta, let Mr. Contractor speak and then we'll wrap out.
You know, what we are talking about, Bombay is an island. Only 10% of our coast is open to the people. What is she talking about? That the whole coastline, you know, this way we will open up the coastline. We don't even have a single place, you know, barring Marine Drive and Borivali. We don't have the coastline open to the people. Only 10%. This would open up.
Okay. We've completely run out of time, Mr. Contractor, but I think point has been well made. But an environmental impact assessment, I think that is what Mumbai High Court has taken a stance, that you have to get it done before taking a decision to proceed with that coastal road project. Hafiz Contractor and Shweta Wagh, thank you very much for speaking to us. And of course, it's back to you, Kritika.
All right, Manisha, thanks for taking us through that interesting discussion. A lot of points left in terms of questions and what lies ahead, but we're going to track that through the day. For now, a very short break on the other side. India's 10-year yield crushes 10 basis points.